It is an honor and a pleasure to be able to stand before you today. My name is Gavin B. I am 12 years old, and I am the founder and president of Kids Against the Death Penalty. I am also a victim of the Texas injustice system. I consider myself a victim because I am personally affected by the death penalty, and it quite literally dominates mine and my entire family's life. See, my uncle, Jeff Wood, was convicted under a law which very few people know about, called the Texas Law of Parties. He was convicted of murder and sentenced to die even though he was not the shooter in the crime, and even though he was not present when the murder took place. Further, my uncle had no knowledge that the murder would even take place. The actual shooter in this crime, Daniel Renault, has already paid the ultimate Texas price with his life and was executed for this crime by the state of Texas back in 2002. The law of parties is an outdated, barbaric law that very few people know about. But nonetheless, it is a law that allows men and women who are practically innocent of murder to be put to death. We are here today to try to help, but we are also here to tell you just how this law breaks apart families. On August 21st, 2008, we came within hours of my uncle's execution. Luckily, he was granted a last-minute stay to further investigate competency issues. But can you imagine having to say your final goodbyes to your loved one? My cousin Paige, Jeff's daughter, tried to commit suicide because she could not handle the pressure of losing her father, or the names that people were calling her for having a father who was a killer, which she is not. However, since that is what he is convicted of, that is what he was referred to as, a murderer. My mom and my aunt Kristen have had mental breakdowns and have had to talk to specialists. Other family members have had to start taking depression medication and anti-anxiety drugs because it has affected them in the worst kinds of ways. It has also affected our schoolwork and our social life. What really gets me though is I can still picture my mom screaming and crying for my uncle when it was time for him to make his journey to the death house. And it is a haunting image. But the victimization goes much further and deeper than just emotional. We've had people chastise us and call us names like prison whores and their more bleeding heart jackasses. We have lost friends, we've had people try to run us over with their trucks while we're protesting, yelling that we should be on death row right along with other scums. We've had guns pulled on us, our parents have lost jobs and income, and some of us have even had to move. Yes, we're definitely victims of the crime as well. And so are all the other family members of those who have loved ones in death row.
We have taken on some pen pals. Unfortunately, some
dead by the state. May they rest in peace. It really does bother me that we have visited and talked to the 7 men in the visitation room at Pulaski, and they have been murdered as well, just as a day later or so. It is a constant struggle to stay positive when all around you is dead or the threat of death. We have no faith in our justice system, but we have changed that one small step at a time. My mom tells us we have a lot of big dreams, but we don't see them clear. We would like to put together some kind of manual for death row inmate families, which provides step-by-step instructions of what one should do and should not do when their loved one is convicted. The manual should also have a complete list of resources or organizations that they can contact for help or guidance. We think this is very important because we had no idea what to do for over 10 years, and that was 10 years wasted. Further, we would like to have a master list of at least 15,000 email addresses of people who are active and willing to take 5 minutes out of their day to sign a petition or write a letter to an inmate. We would also like to start some kind of program to help out the children of death row inmates, maybe by providing them with school supplies each year or providing Christmas presents from their fathers. Now, we haven't figured out how we're going to do all this yet, but we're working on it, because being a victim is no fun, and we don't want others to have to go through the same kind of hell that we have gone through. Being a family member of a Texas death row inmate is bad, you know, but being one that has come so close to execution is about the worst feeling in the world. You feel utterly helpless, or entirely feeling helpless, which is why we're here. So please help us help others. Call or write all of the Texas representatives and voice your opinions on the law parties and the death penalty altogether. We can make a difference one at a time. Thank you for your attention today, and God bless.
Thank you.